Alrighty, here is a little extra for Cubase users. So we will look in this video how to configure EuCon controller, specifically Avid Control in iPad, to be used with Cubase when creating music, mixing, mastering, and so on and so forth. So let's dive into configure this and see how it is done. Okay, so to use Avid Control with Cubase, you need to go to Avid Download Center and then find the EuCon controller software that you need to download and install in order to get started. So you basically go into the Avid Download Center and you find the EuCon from there and you download the latest software and then you install it. After you have installed it, it will appear over here as an EU control, and then here basically is where the configuration takes place. The next step after you have installed the EuCon into your system, in this case in Mac, I'm running a Mac, you need to go into the system settings. So you open the system settings and then you go into the point where you have EuCon over here. And here you basically need to, as it says, to configure drag Mackie application into the list. So what you need to do is that you need to drag Cubase into the list, and then it will say that it will now create and configure and change the MIDI port. So system must be restarted for MIDI port changes to take effect. So now you click an OK, and then you need to restart the system in order to get it properly configured. So let's restart the system. So now once you have restarted the system, this should still look like this. So in EuCon settings, in the system settings section, you scroll down to the EuCon section. Now you see, of course, the Cubase over here, and then it defines what MIDI ports it will be used. So 1 to 4. And in order to kind of verify that it's also configured into your MIDI audio settings, it's good to go there and verify and basically start the MIDI audio setting application. So you go and start MIDI audio, and then you should see actually this Euphorix MIDI here. This is pretty much the four ports that it configured to be used when dealing with EuCon controllers. So we can close this software, and then we can also close the system setting. Now everything should be okay over there. The next phase for us is to kind of see that in the EuCon we have the controller present. All right, so I'm sharing now also my iPad so that you can see what I'm doing over there. And the next phase is that we open up the EuCon settings, and it's empty, of course, as I don't have any controller present. But at the point when I start Avid Control in my iPad, it will appear over here. So now, in case you would not have it in My Surfaces, so that you would have a situation like this, so that you have it here, so then you need to go and select it and add it into your surfaces. So My Surfaces, these are the ones that are now active in my configuration. So this is how it should look like when everything is properly configured in the EuCon settings and with Avid Control, and it's running in your iPad. So next we will actually then hop into Cubase. Okay, so in Cubase, what you need to do basically is that you go into the studio and you go into the setup. And here you see, of course, currently set up controllers and things, your audio system and so on and so forth. So you need to go here to add a device, and you go here and you basically then select EuCon as a new device to be added. And when you're adding it, it basically auto-configures everything. And as you can see, the iPad came into life. So now that's pretty much it that you need to do in Cubase to get it done. So once you have done all the preparation work and all that configuration properly, getting it running in Cubase is quite easy busy. So then now once we are here in Cubase, and if I basically open up a mixer, so I have everything here, and so I have all my tracks, of course, in here. Then I can go in my iPad and for example go to the vocal track and then, you know, work with faders or solo it only. And so that's pretty straightforward, as you can see. And now you can utilize the Avid control in your iPad with Cubase. So you can go into your tracks, then you can go and select the track that you want to modify. And then here you have, of course, these controls that you can kind of do solo and solo like one track or multiple tracks. So you can select what type of controls you want to do or clear everything. So it's actually extremely handy. The Avid control works great with Cubase, and it's quite convenient to use. So yeah, that's pretty much it. And let's do one other thing here still. Let's go into the tracks and let's like solo that one. Then we go into the channel mode. And in channel mode, if I go into the inserts, I do see that, you know, what kind of inserts I have there. And then I can also, you know, work with my inserts over there and so mute them, bypass them and so on and so forth. So, and then you could also program these soft keys in a way that they do commands towards Cubase. So you can create an old profile in EuCon for Cubase. So you need to actually go here and work with soft keys. So you can do your own profile for Cubase and what is kind of shown here. You have actually a default here already, but of course you can modify this all these things from the EuCon settings. So if I now go into the soft keys, you can see that I have all these now. What I see here, I see also in iPad. And then it's as easy as you basically go and select the button and change the way it functions. So all that works nice and smooth with with Cubase. Okay. Alrighty. So that was how to configure Avid control to be used with Cubase. Remember to subscribe for the channel for more content. Thanks for watching. Bye now.